We've just shown you how to activate i3, the Polybar in i3. So let's get out of here and show you how to activate Polybar in OpenBox. So that's another possibility. You can use that as well if you like. So this is now Tint 2. Tint 2 is available in here in the preferences. We have here some references to the Tint 2 and the Tint 2 GUI. So if you don't like this bar, but rather like something else like Polybar, then you can do as well. So first of all, install or follow the video how to install it. We need Arch Merge configuration and we need Polybar to build. That's in another separate tutorial. This is how to activate Polybar in OpenBox. You know that OpenBox starts with the .config. Let's put them here. And in .config, you have this OpenBox folder that's important for you and the OB menu generator as well. So this is two important folders for OpenBox. When you go in here, you have this auto start. Then we open click it open. Then you can make it a little bit bigger. We have already a nice little sentence in here. All you have to do is say, I'm gonna get rid of Tint 2 and I'm gonna activate this config polybar launch.sh. So that's what it's what's in intention. Okay, so all you have to do now is get out of here. So super X is what I pressed, log out, log back in, and wait for it. And there you have it. So this is now Polybar. You have an activated Polybar on the top, and you have here the workspaces that you can navigate to. And every time you open something, anything really, it show up down here, Eric File Manager. So this thing here goes up here and you can just switch. These elements are all in the configuration file, which we will discuss in another video. But here it is, Polybar is activated on OpenBox.